Honorable members, farewell to retiring members. Honorable members, today we bid farewell to four of our colleagues from the Union Territory of Jammu and Kashmir, namely Mir Mohammed Fayaz and Sri Samsher Singh Manhas, who are retiring on 10th of February, and Sri Ghulam Nabi Azad and Sri Najir Ahmad Lave, who will be retiring on 15th February 2021. Honorable members, retirement from this august house only means taking leave from the house, and it only marks a new beginning in the service of our people, of their respective areas, as well as the country. As such, retirement is only a comma, not a break, in the chosen path of serving the nation, or a full stop even. The life after retirement from this august house offers immense opportunities to fulfill the mission of serving the country. I am sure the retiring members are leaving the house with a sense of fulfillment and contentment. Having discharged their responsibilities to the best of their abilities and conviction, we bid a farewell to the leader of the opposition, Sri Ghulam Nabi Azad ji, with a heavy heart. He has been a voice of sanity in the nation's public life for the last few decades, having made significant contribution both in the government and in the opposition. He has served as a member of this august house for as many as 28 years and one of the veterans of this house. Sri Azad ji has been rightly honored with the Outstanding Parliamentary Award for the year 2015. As a member of both the House of Parliament, Sri Azad conducted himself in an exemplary manner and has been a role model for the first-time members. He speaks softly but conveys his point of view effectively, which should be the way. During the last 3 years as chairman of this august house, I have benefited richly from the inputs and wise counsel of Sri Ghulam Nabi Azad ji in resolving various difficult situations. As the chairman, I will be missing the service of Sri Azad ji. Mir Mohammed Fayaz, Sri Samsher Singh Manhas and Sri Najir Ahmad Lave has also contributed to the deliberations of this house by raising issues of regional and national importance from time to time as members of various parliamentary committees, and also used to take opportunities as and when they are given to contribute to the debates about their respective states. As they hail from a sensitive state, Jammu Kashmir and the Union Territory of Ladakh and the Union Territory now of this province, they always represented the will of the people in their own way to bring to the attention of this august house. I place on record my appreciation for the courtesy, consideration and cooperation extended to chair by the retiring members. I hope that the retiring members will continue to serve the people in different capacities with the same zeal, enthusiasm, vigor and spirit of service which they have exhibited in this house. You are all only retired but not tired from offering public service. So please continue your services, and in a manner that will really impress upon the people and add dignity and decorum to the public life in our country. I'm sure, as I told you, I don't have more words to explain about the absence of Sri Gulam Nabi Azad ji. Already we are deprived permanently of the service of two of our colleagues, Sushri Mati Sushma Swaraj and Sri Arun Jaitley. God has been unkind to them. And now two temporary miss Sri Gulam Nabi Azad ji from this house will be definitely a painful for all of us, and I hope that these retiring members, including Gulam Nabi ji, will be able to come back. And I wish all the retiring members good health, happiness, and many more years of service to the nation. The Honorable